That makes me 72 and proud as hell. I come from Detroit, as you know. Big family, 5 kids. We have 4 girls and 1 boy. We all play music. My father played music all his life. He gave us all every lesson we wanted. We all play at least 3 or 4 instruments each, just the way we grew up. So I picked up a bass at the age of 14. And I never put it down again. Started a band with my sisters called The Pleasure Seekers. And that band lasted from 1964 up until 1971, at which point Mickey Most, big famous record producer, he did everybody, he offered me a solo contract. So I left my home, I left my family, I left my band, I went to England. And I relocated as a solo artist, and the success did not happen right away, so I spent about 18 very lonely months. But finally, May of 1973, I had my first number one with Can the Can. That was not your cue. Okay, so that started the whole ball rolling for me. It started the recording sessions, the photo sessions, the TV shows, the nonstop touring around the world, the constant jet lag. Loved it. Then in 1977, I branched out a little bit, and I got a part in Happy Days. Do you know that show here? Happy Days, yeah. I played another Tuscadero for 3 seasons. That was great fun. And I went into other TV series in England. Then I went to musicals. I did Annie Get Your Gun in the West End. Yeah. And I wrote a musical, which I started to. Then, what happened next? Oh, I start all the time. I'm still doing my gigs. I'm still touring. I then started to be a disc jockey. And for 15 years, I was on BBC Radio 2. So, and would you like to hear my radio voice?
Yeah.
Hi everybody, this is Susie Quattro, welcome to the show. Okay, then I started to write books, and I've now published my 6th book, so I'm very proud of that. Let me see now, we're coming up to date now. At the end of 2019, my documentary finally came out called Susie Q. If you haven't seen it, see it. It was top of the Amazon charts for a long time, really, really good. Warts and All documentary. And the one thing I want to share with you just before we do the rest of the set, what was the year, 2016? The most surprising thing that ever happened to me in my entire life, I found myself standing on stage at Cambridge University, dressed in a cap and a gown, becoming honorary Doctor of Music. I don't even have a high school diploma. Yeah. All right, I'm going to make you feel good now. We're going to go to 1978. Just let me get my boyfriend.
Yeah. I'm not ready yet.
Wrong room!
Yeah.